Coming from the world-renowned Lincoln Center, Jason Olane says the difference in this year's Jazz Festival is hard to miss.
Last year when I saw the festival, there were shows in like hotel ballrooms. And the concerts were all very good. But one of the things everybody seemed to have some interest in is showcasing the island itself. And that's what's happening this year with concerts at this Groselet Park. I think that's the first one, Groselet Park. So another one is the ramp. Mm-hmm. Which marina. Is and mm-hmm. and in the marina
Shangri-La as well.
And Shangri-La, so yeah. Four different places where you can see this music, and plus we were just in Anse-l'Oreille and Labrie. So
and for the first time we have a jazz excursion on a boat, yeah. The Pearl.
That's right. So you're also on the water.
With
so it's yeah, it's kind of jazz all around the island. So that's pretty unique, I think, as far as festivals go. So something else for people to come out and get excited about.
According to Olane, while the overseas jazz artists are here on island, they will be hosting workshops for upcoming local jazz musicians, grooming them for the big stage.
You've got Gregory Porter, who's here for a few days, but we've got Christian McBride, who's already on the island, who's going to be here through Sunday. We've got Lettucey, who arrives, is going to be here through the week. We've got Patrick Bartley, great alto saxophone player, and clarinetist, and Russell Hall, and Etienne Charles. And they're going to be here all week collaborating with local artists, teaching, doing education, jamming with each other. Lettucey's going to be sitting in with Gregory Porter. I wouldn't be surprised if Christian McBride and Lettucey do something together, or Russell Hall and Christian McBride, plus the jam session that Maneva mentioned. This is a place where musicians, even if they all live in the same area, like in New York City or someplace, they don't get to see each other. They only see each other on the road at other jazz festivals. So this is a place where they get to see each other and hang out and also interact with the community. So again, I don't think there's any other festival that I know of that has this many artists and residents that are spending so much time on the island. So that's pretty exciting.
Jam sessions will be held at the Big Chef Steakhouse on Rodney Bay, free of charge, and the public is encouraged to mingle with the artists.
This is a free event as well. We're talking about three jam sessions, the 9th, the 10th, and the 11th. So that is Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. These kick off post the core events. So once you're done, whichever venue you're at, make your way to Big Chef. And we're inviting the musicians and the public to just come and hang. And there is a bandstand there with a fully decked out band with equipment, a backline. You can get on there and actually play a tune or two with Patrick Bartley and Russell Hall and Christian McBride and whoever is there. And we're talking about a coming together of our local artists as well as our international and regional artists, mm-hmm. all in a spirit of camaraderie, doing what we really, really love, enjoying the music, enjoying the jazz music. And those jam sessions are free. So we're inviting as well the musicians on the island, our local musicians and regional and international artists, to come together for that at Big Chef.
Approximately 30 persons from the international media are expected to arrive here in St. Lucia by Wednesday. For the DBS News World, I am Alex Busquet.